Hi, Cam here from Empanitum. Today we're going to talk about a feature we've added in the latest version of the motor control software as well as the motors. It's called failover. Failover is a feature or a function that you want the motor to do in the event that it loses communication with its controller. And depending on your application, you might want the motor to change speeds or you might want the motor to stop if it loses communication. So we're going to show you in this demonstration how to turn it on and actually show you what's going to happen when it enters this mode. You can see I'm running the software, the latest version 2.76, but I'm not connected to the motor. So to enable these settings, since it's from the factory, they're sent disabled, you need to go ahead and turn these settings on. The first thing you need to do is connect to the motor. So we hit the connect button in the upper left-hand corner, and you can see the operational mode I'm going to be running it in. My motor's going to be running at 1500 RPM when I start it in a clockwise direction. But I need to turn on the features. As I mentioned, they're sent from the factory disabled. So go down here to the lower left corner and click on parameter settings. You go to the right where it says failover settings. You click on that, and the first thing you need to do is enable the settings. So here you click enable, you go back up, you hit apply, which writes these settings to the motor. And now it's going to let me physically change the settings since they are now enabled. The first box tells the motor how long should it wait before it goes into failover mode. In the event it loses communication, I've got it set to 5 seconds. So after 5 seconds, it's going to do this new feature that I've detected in failover mode. In my particular example, I want it to go to a new speed, but depending on your application, you actually might want to stop the motor, and both of these are options. The next button is what do you want the motor to do if it resumes communication? The options here are to go back to the original speed, which in my case is 1500, or if you leave it disabled, it'll go to this new speed and maintain that indefinitely. And the last button is, this is the speed you want the motor to maintain when it goes into fail-safe mode. So after 5 seconds, in my particular example, it's going to go from 1500 RPM to 1000. Now I'm going to go ahead and start the motor and show you what this looks like. Now that we've set up these parameters, let's go ahead and do a real test and watch what happens with the real-life motor. Before I do that, though, you can see in my left hand over here is a tachometer, and there's a shaft with a piece of tape on it that the tachometer can read the actual speed of the motor. Once the laptop is disconnected, we need to have a way to measure the speed without relying on the laptop. So I'm going to go ahead and start this, get the motor up to speed, break connection, and put it into failover mode. So I'm starting on the motor. You can see in the upper left-hand corner of the display is the set speed, and the actual speed is on the upper right. And it'll level off at 1500 once it gets to the right speed. While it's doing that, I'm observing with the tachometer in my left hand over here. You can actually see the speed measured on that along with the laptop. So we've leveled off at 1500 RPM, and the tachometer agrees with it. I'm going to break connection between the laptop and the motor by clicking this button in the upper left-hand corner. Once I click it, it'll stop talking to the motor, and we should enter failover mode in about 5 seconds. So I'm going to click this button. And you can hear the motor slowing down. If you remember, the setting for failover was 1,000 RPM, so it should level off at 1,000, and you can see the tachometer is indicating that. So it'll run at this speed indefinitely, but the way to simulate the restoring function, once I click this button in the upper left-hand corner, the laptop will start talking to the motor, and it should go back to its preset speed of 1500 RPM. I restore communication, speeding up. And now we're back to 1500 and the tachometer, and the laptop agrees with it. You can see in the upper right-hand corner of the laptop, it's the speed we expected it to be. So this is a test and a demonstration of the failover mode. I hope that helps. If you have any questions, just drop us a note at goinfinitum.com. Thanks for watching.